Welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video frequency in Excel function, watch the video till the end. And if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone. Today we have a topic that we are supposed to discuss is the frequency in Excel function. Let's understand this in a complete detail format. So frequency in Excel function, this function is in Excel, it calculates the number of times the data values that occurs within a given range of values. So it returns to vertical array of the number of corresponding to the frequency of each value in the range. It is basically, if you can say that, it's a built-in function in Excel, and it is categorized as statistical function. How exactly the frequency formula is used in Excel? You can write that as equal to frequency. And you will see there is two things, that is data array and the beans array. Well, the data array over here is a required an array of a reference or a set of values which frequency is to be counted. The second is the beans array. It is required and it's an array or a reference to intervals into which the values of the data array are to be grouped. Now the frequency returns an array of the values, and it must be entered as an array formula. It always has to be entered in the array formula. Now for entering this formula, what you can just simply do, you can press Control Shift and Enter, okay, or Command Shift and Enter in Mac, and the cells into which the output is required. So those cells are supposed to be selected first, and then the frequency formula. Now, the frequency function in Excel, it returns a frequency distribution. Okay, and the distribution is of the data array in the beans array interval. Now, the output is always, remember, it's always going to be one more than the number of elements in the beans array. The extra element in the returned array corresponding to the count of the values is higher than the highest value of the beans array. So suppose the beans array, it contains the elements such as 2, 4, 6, and the function will return to as, you know, something like 2, 2, minus 4, 4, minus 6, which is greater than closely around 6, and so on and so forth. So if the data array, if it contains, let's say, no values, say the data array contains no values, then in that particular scenario, the Excel frequency function returns an array of 0. And if the beans array contains no value, the Excel frequency function returns the total number of elements given in the data array. So, the frequency in the Excel is widely used function in statistics. Sometimes it is required to understand the frequency distribution of a given data rather than just data. So, for example, let's say there is an age of individuals in a population varies to great extent, and thus they are visualized in the form of frequency. So similarly, the marks obtained by each student of a class are clubbed into the terms of frequency to understand the overall performance of the class. We'll take an illustration to understand this. Suppose you have numbers for which you want to calculate the frequency. The number is, let's say, 1, 2, 3, 2, 4, 6. 2, 3, 4, and 5, and they are given over here in the array. The numbers are to be clubbed into the interval of, let's say, 2, 4, and 6, given in D3 to D5. So, to calculate the frequency, first select the four cells, you'll write is equal to frequency. First select this from B3 to B11, that's the data array, and then let's put up the beans array. Close the bracket, and there we go, you have an answer. Control Shift and Enter. Okay, so while entering, you should do Control Shift and Enter, right? So since, or what you can do while writing the formula only, you select the whole thing and then start writing is equal to frequency. This is your data array. This is your beans array, and then do Control Shift and Enter, and you will have the answer for all the rest of the datas. Okay, so the given output is 3, 4, 2, and 0, corresponding to the interval. that is 2, 2, -4, 4, and 6. So if you select only 3 cells instead of 4, the count will be greater than 6 and 6 will be omitted. Okay, so how to use this function in Excel? See, Excel frequency function is very simple, very easy to use. Let's understand the working of the frequency in Excel by some of the examples. The example number one is right here. Suppose you carried out a survey and collected the data of the height. This is the height. Some of the interval data is given to you. Now you want to calculate the frequency of the height in the following. This data. How you're going to do? The interval is 155, 160, 165, 170. That is given in E4 to E7. So to calculate the frequency, first you need to select the 5 consecutive cells. Okay, once you select the 5 consecutive cells, you need to enter is equal to frequency, select the first data array, and then the beans array, control shift and enter, and you can see you have an answer here. Well, it will return to the frequency as shown above, 1, 2, 3, 3, and 2. Okay. Let's take one more example. Suppose, let's say you have a list of student IDs and you have a maths function, one or more other subjects in your class along with your subject. Okay. So now all those who have failed, or they will be considered as fail. And you need to know the number of the students who have failed. So to identify this, you can use the syntax. Okay. Something like this. How you're going to use this? Well, it's as simple as that. You will just write sum, open the bracket, you'll say frequency, inside that frequency the data array will be B4 to B9, comma beans array will also be B4 to B9. Okay. Once you do that, close the bracket greater than 0 and then close two other brackets. Well, you get an answer as 4. So if you see the syntax here, the frequency is B4 to B9 and B4 to B9. That will calculate the frequency of the data B4 to B9 using the interval B4 to B9. So it will return 1120200. So the frequency will be greater than 0 and will check if the opt-in frequency is greater than 0. So it returns with the logical conclusion. Suppose in the example number 3, you have a data of customer that have visited a supermarket in the day along with your with the time of their visit in the cells over here that is mentioned from B4 to C20 that is shown here. Well, let's start working on these numbers. If you see, there are names and time that is given. Now you want to see at which time interval the customer visited the most in the store. This will help you to plan the employees' working hours in the efficient way. So the store opens at, let's say, 11 a.m. and it closes as 8 p.m. So let's first decide the time interval, and we can use the following intervals for the sake of the simplicity. Now select the cells in the frequency table to be obtained from G4 to G13 in the case, and since the store closes at 8 p.m. we do not select the cells greater than the 8 p.m. as it will be a zero scenario. Okay. So select the whole cell here, or complete. You will have to write the formula as is equal to frequency. Data array will be the names. The beans array is going to be, select this, control shift and enter. See 0000 and so on and so forth. Now instead of here, just write G14. To G13, control shift and enter, still remains the same. So it will return to the frequency of the customer visits to the store in the most of the case. Now let's understand what are the things that you should remember. Well, the frequency formula in Excel is entered as an array formula, and a range of the adjacent cells is selected into which the distribution is required to appear. So to enter the frequency formula in Excel, you need to press control plus shift plus enter. This is what you need to enter, right? So you can use this command, like for x number of elements in the beans array, make sure to select the x plus 1 number of cells while entering the frequency formula in Excel. Now the extra cells returns the number of the values in the data array that is greater than the third interval. That's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and loved watching this video or enjoyed this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone once again.